Today we are going to see chapter number 2, that is final account of partnership firm of standard 12 comma subject account. So today we are going to see one more sum. This is the part 14 of the chapter number 2 and illustration number 8, where we are going to see how to prepare trading account, profit and loss account, profit and loss appropriation account, partners capital account, as well as balancing. Let's see illustration number 8. Let's see illustration number 8. So here we can see the trial balance, and in the trial balance we are able to see there is a capital account as well as current account. So here we are going to prepare current account and capital account balance. Straight we will write in the balancing. Here there are the other things that we need to consider while we are going to calculate the sum. So in that, very first adjustment is telling us that valuation of closing stock is 15,000, out of which 10,000 and 15,000 goods have market value less than the book value by 12% and 20% respectively. So here we need to calculate closing stock, and for that let's make the working note number 1. So here working note 1, so that is for the closing stock. Closing stock valuation is given to us 15,000. So in 15,000, 10% closing stock and 15% closing stock. So here let's calculate 10% of 15,000, that is rupees 1500, and 15% of 15,000 is it? Rupees 2250. Now, what they are telling us that the 10% and 15% goods have market value less than the book value by 12% as well as 20%. So here 12% of 1500 will be 180, and here 20% of 2250 will be 450. So here if we are going to deduct from 1500, 180, balancing amount will be 1320, and here it will be 1800. Now the other stock will be, if from 15,000 we are going to deduct 2250 and 1500, then the balancing amount, that will be 75%, and that is rupees 11,250, and it is having the same value. So that will be rupees 11,250. So now let's make the valuation of the stock, closing stock. So that will be 1320, 1800 and 11,250. So that will be rupees 14,370. So this is our value of the closing stock. Now, after adjustment number 1, adjustment number 2 is for the stationary stock. So for the stationary stock also, it is given to us that the closing stock is 31st 317 rupees 500, and in the trial balance opening stock of stationary is given to us. So this is working note number 2. What is for the stationary? And that is here, opening stock of stationery is it? The opening stock, it is on 1460 200. Then the purchase of stationery is, that is 1000. And from this, if we are going to deduct closing stock, this 500, so balancing amount 700 will be shown in the profit and loss account, and this will be, closing stock will be shown in the balance sheet. So in the profit and loss account we are going to write 700. So that is adjustment number 2. Now let's see adjustment number 3, where here it is given a furniture of rupees 600 sold to Kishan for 400 on 1/10/16, which is recorded in the the salesman. So here, let's prepare the popping note number 3 for the furniture. So here, we can see that furniture of rupees 600, which is sold for 400. So there is a loss. So before we calculate the loss, we have to calculate the depreciation. So balance of furniture as per trial balance, it is. In the trial balance, balance is given 1500. From that we are going to deduct the sale of furniture. That is 600. So now in the balance sheet we are going to see furniture of rupees 900. Now from 600 we have to calculate the depreciation. So here depreciation calculation is equal to opening balance of furniture is how much? 600. On that we have used it for 6 months. So depreciation minus depreciation at the rate of 5% on 6 months. So that will be here rupees 15. So our book value on book value as on date of the sale, that will be 585. This is the book value. So now this furniture of 585 we have sold for 400. So balancing amounts will, balancing amount 185 will be our loss on sale of furniture. So this 585 we supposed to debit it to profit and loss account, and the again we are going to calculate depreciation on 900 for whole year. So that we are going to calculate. So this is the working note for the furniture. So this was the adjustment number 3. Now let's talk about the next. Increase in the rate of depreciation to motors at machine at 10%. So here on machine we have to calculate the depreciation for that. Let's see working note number 4. So here machine balance as per trial balance of machine is, it is related to machinery. So balance as per trial balance. In the trial balance, machine account is given to us rupees 8,325, and depreciation is also given in the trial balance. So depreciation as per trial balance, so that will be 675. So that will be total of this will be 9000. So on 9000 again we are going to calculate the depreciation. So let's depreciation as per adjustment, they are asking us to calculate depreciation at 10%. So that will be 900. So our balancing amount will be 8100 will be written in the balancing. So this is the depreciation on machinery adjustment number 4. Adjustment number 5, provide 5% depreciation on furniture. So that will be straight we are going to write down. Again adjustment number 6 is relate to bad debt, that will soon we will see in the balance sheet straight. Again 7 also it is related to discount reserve, so that is also going to be finished. Then goods of rupees 3000 withdrawn by Meera for personal use on 1/1/17, it is recorded in the sales book. So this adjustment have 4 effect. So here we are going to it is a withdrawn, so we are going to deduct from the purchase, then we are going to indicate as a drawing. Again here it is recorded as a sales, so for that we are going to deduct from the sales, and again we are going to deduct from the data. So there will be a 4 effect of this adjustment. Then there is a calculate 5% interest on capital that we are going to do, and 2000 annual salary given to the Raja. That also we will straight make in the final account. So here we are finished with all the working note. Now let's start the sum. For that we are going to prepare trading account, profit and loss account, profit and loss appropriation account, partners capital account and balance sheet. Let's prepare it. Question number 8. Radha and Meera are the partners sharing profit loss in the proportion of 3:2. Their trial balance is as on 31st 3/17 given to us. So here in the trial balance, very first thing is given to us is a capital. Here capital as well as current, both account is given. So capital straight we will write in the balance sheet. So that is capital account of Radha and Meera. So Radha's capital account is 20,000 and Meera's capital account is 10,000. So here again we can see that there is an adjustment number 9 on capital account. So adjustment number 9, calculate 10% interest on partner's capital. So 10% of 20,000 and 10,000, that will be 2,000 and 1,000. So that we are going to credit to the current account. So here we are going to leave one line for the balance. And then we will write very first interest on capital by interest on capital at the rate of 10%. So that will be 2,000 and 1,000. And this is the adjustment. Second effect of this will be on the profit and loss appropriation account debit side. Right, interest to interest on capital, that is for Radha and Meera, that is 2,000, 1,000, total will be 3,000. So that is, after that another account is a current account. So current account balance for Radha, it is given on the debit side. So that will write on the debit side to balance breakdown. For Radha it is 5,000 debit balance, for Meera it is credit balance by balance brought down, and for Meera it is 1,000. So right, after current account another account is given to us is a purchase and sales. So purchase is on the debit side, that we will write on the trading account after leaving one line for the opening stock. Second line will be for the purchase, and here purchase is of 15,000, and here again adjustment. So adjustment number 3 and 8 both is given to us. So very first thing we will write sales and purchase. Here sales account is of 32,000. Now let's see the adjustment number 3. A furniture of rupees 600 sold to Kishan for 400 on 1/10/16, which is recorded in sales book. So here furniture, so we have to write in the asset account also. So let's write furniture account here. Very first asset is a furniture, which is in the trial balance it is given for the 1500. From there we have sold for 600, so that we are going to deduct from here, and 900 is going to be remain, and that 600 here we are going to deduct from 600, we are going to deduct, it is for 400 from the sales, because it is selling price of the furniture is 400. So furniture sales, so that will be 400, that will deduct from here. And the effect of 600, that is the it is the loss on sale of furniture, so that is going to record here as in to loss, that is according to the working note, loss on sale of furniture that we already calculated, and that loss is 185, and depreciation on furniture that we are going to, we already calculated depreciation. Depreciation that will be sold furniture, that is of rupees 15, and now we have to calculate depreciation on 900, that will be doing now
But before that, let's see the effect of another 400. That is, we have sold the furniture to the Kishan and Kishan haven't given us money. So for that, we are going to write here that the Kishan's account. So here, this is the 400. So here we have made the effect of sales, and for the sales here we have calculated loss. Again, depreciation also we have calculated, and from 600. So here again we have to deduct the same amount from the debtors. So here from debtors we are going to deduct the 16,000 from that sales of furniture. That is 400. So that. So here 600, for 600 debit effect is, credit effect is this, and debit effect is here, here and here for 400. So here we are finished with the adjustment number 3. Now let's see the adjustment number 8. Adjustment number 8 is telling us that goods of rupees 3000 withdrawn by Meera for personal use on 1/17. It is recorded in sales book. So goods taken, it will be deducted from the purchase as a goods withdrawn. Goods withdrawn. That is how much? 3000. So that we are going to deduct, and it will be treated as a drawing. So let's write to drawing account. So that is how much on for Meera, it is 3000. Again, what they are telling us that it is by mistake treated as a sales. So that same we are going to deduct by wrongly recorded as a sales. 3000. So that is again we are going to deduct. So here another effect of that will be, it is going to deduct it from the debtors. So let's deduct it from the debtors. So for 15,600 minus wrongly recorded. So that is for 3000. So balancing amount will be 12,600. So here we are finished with adjustment number 3 as well as adjustment number 8. Next is a receivable as well as payable. Receivable payable is also called debtors and creditors. So here in the receivable we have already returned the 16,000. Payable we supposed to write 9,800. So here we'll write payable, and payable will be 9,000. Payable is also called creditors. So here we will write creditors is of 9,800. And here debtors, there is an adjustment. Adjustment number 3, we already done 6 and 7. Let's do that. Adjustment number 6 is telling us write off 600 from debtors as bad debt and provide 5% bad debt reserve. So here minus bad debt of adjustment will be 600. So balancing amount will be 12,000. On that, we have to calculate bad debt reserve at the rate of 5%. That is also of adjustment. So 5% of 12,000 will be, 5% of 12,000 will be again here 600. So balancing amount will be 11,400. On that, again we have to calculate discount reserve, and discount reserve is of 2% of 2% of 11,400. That will be 228. So the outer side column amount will be 11,1172. So that is, now let's make the other effect of bad debts in the profit and loss account. So that will be here bad debt that we are going to write down. It is of adjustment. Adjustment bad debt will be 600 plus bad debt reserve of adjustment. That will be 600. So total will be 1200. From that, we are going to deduct bad debt reserve of trial balance. When if we come, we'll do that. Now, let's make the discount reserve. So discount reserve again, to discount. So discount we can see in the trial balance, that discount is 125. From 125, if we are going to add the discount reserve of adjustment, that will be 228. And then we will see that discount reserve of trial balance. So that it, when it will come, we are going to see that. So here we are finished with receivable as well as payable and adjustment number 367. Now let's see the motor car. Motor car we can see here it is for 12,000. So that motor car we are going to write in the balance sheet straight. That motor car. Here we have to leave line for the depreciation that we are going to calculate later on. So here motor car will be of 12,000. So that is after motor car another account is goods return, that is debit credit both is given, that means it is purchase return as well as sales return. So here we can see that the debit is our sales return, so that we are going to write down minus sales return is 1000 and purchase return is of rupees 500, so that is purchase return 500. Now, after that, let's see the other account, that is the sundry expense. Sundry expense supposed to be written in the profit and loss account. So then we are going to write down over here sundry expense. That is sundry expense of rupees 800. So that is after that other account is it. Provident fund and provident fund contribution. So provident fund we already discussed yesterday. It is our liability and it's supposed to be written in the liability side. Very first thing is a provident fund. And provident fund is 4000. And contribution to provident fund, it is a 4000 is a liability and 200 is a expense, so that's supposed to be written over here to contribution to provident fund. So that is to contribution to PF and that will be 200. After that other account is a bank and cash. Bank is a bank overdraft, so it's supposed to be written bank overdraft. And that will be bank overdraft will be how much? On the credit side amount will be bank overdraft. So credit side amount is a 19,847. And cash amount is it. Cash balance is of 2,500. So this. After bank and cash, another is a opening stock. Opening stock supposed to be written on top. Two opening stock. And that is of 9,000. After that, another account is a bank interest. Bank interest is our expense and supposed to be debited to the profit and loss account. So here, we are going to debit bank expense. So, bank expense to bank interest. And that is 142. After that, another account is a bank interest, then there is a billing. So billing will write in the balance sheet. Billing is a of 12,950. So that we will write in the balance sheet straight. Billing, there is no depreciation on the billing. So that is 12,950. After billing, another account is stationary stock. And stationary, for stationary stock, we have already made the working note. According to that working note, we are going to straight write stationary in the in the profit and loss account. So that will be 700 to stationery. Working note, according to working note. So here we are not going to write everything again. Straight we will write 700 here and closing stock of stationery here. Closing stock of stationery, that is 500. So that is going to be written over here. So that is according to the working note. Now after stationery opening stock purchase, there is a bad debt return. So bad debt return here, it is given 700. So that will be treated as a bad debt return is treated in our income. So by bad debt return, and that is 700. So that we will write straight in the profit and loss account. After bad debt return, another account is a sale of newspaper, that is also our income. So that sale of newspaper, by sale of newspaper, and that will be 1000. After that, another account is a professional tax. Professional tax is an expense of the business and supposed to be dedicated to profit and loss account, to professional tax. And that is how much professional tax is 800. So there straight we will write 800. Afterwards, another account is a patent. Patent supposed to be written in the balance it as an intangible asset. So patent. Patent is how much it is for? 4000. After patent, another account is a trademark, and trademark also supposed to be written in the balance it trademark. So that will be trademark is of 5000. And after that, another account is a carriage inward. Carriage inward supposed to be written in the trading account. So that we are going to write down in the 2, carriage inward. Carriage inward account is a 200. And afterwards, after carriage inward, another account is a discount. And discount, we have discount allowed, we already written. Discount received, we are going to write down. Discount by discount received. And it is discount received is 325. And another account is after discount received, another is a machine. And machine as per the working note number 4. Here straight we are going to write down machine of rupees 9000. Here machine. We have already write the working note. So here straight we will write 8100, and depreciation will write here. So machine no depreciation will be, depreciation for the machine will be 900. So that we will write over here. After machine, another account is depreciation on motor car. So depreciation on motor car, that we are going to write down here. Motor car depreciation. Depreciation on motor car 2000. Straight we will write here. That is how much? 2000. So that also we will write straight. And then depreciation on motor car. Then there is a freight. Freight supposed to be written in a trading account. So that will be freight amount is in 350. So that is in the trading account. After freight, another account is a discount reserve. So this is the discount reserve of trial balance. So that we are going to write down. Discount reserve of trial balance. And that will be 250. So here let's calculate this. 353 minus 250. So outer side amount will be 103. So that is discount reserve 250. And afterwards, bad debt reserve, that is 1000. So that that is how supposed to be written. Here, 1000. So here, vendor reserve of trial balance 1000. So balancing amount will be 200. That is also supposed to be written in the amount column. So that is finished. Now let's see the next thing. That is investment of provident fund. So investment supposed to be written over here. So here we are going to write down investment of PF. So that will be investment of PF will be of 4000. So that is 4000. Here we are going to write down 4000. And then after investment PF, another account is interest on provident fund. So that will be our current liability and it's supposed to be written here. Interest on provident fund. And that will be 240. So that's it. Now, afterwards, another account is a interest on provident fund. Then there is a 9% Kanaya loan. So here we have to calculate interest on that. So very first, let's write the Kanaya's loan. So that will be 7000. Kanaya's loan will be 7000. 9% Kanaya's loan. And that is 7000. And interest on Kanaya's loan that we have to calculate. That will be 7000 at the rate of 9% for 9 months. So that will be interest on Kanaya's loan will be, total amount will be 525. From that we know that 315 is already paid. So outstanding interest on loan will be 210. So here interest on Kanaya's loan, that will be 210. And here interest on Kanaya's loan, that is our expense. So it is, we are going to write here interest on loan. So 315 plus outstanding 210. So total will be 525. So that is. Now after Kanaya's loan, another account is it. Insurance premium, out of which 400 is for the year ending on 3617. So that will be prepaid insurance premium. So insurance premium we are going to write here. To insurance premium 600 and outstanding will be minus prepaid. Insurance premium will be 100. So balancing amount will be 500. This 100, it is prepaid insurance premium will be our asset. So prepaid insurance 100. So that is. After that, another account is salary and wages, that is supposed to be debited to profit and loss account. So here we are going to write down salary and wages. So here we don't have space, so we are going to write down salary. Otherwise, we have to write on top salary and wages. Salary and wages is how much? So here it is given 3730. After that, another account is a furniture that we already made it. And now, last thing is a dead stock. That is measuring unit that is supposed to be written over here. Dead stock. So dead stock is of ₹150. And damage is expense, so that is supposed to be debited to trading account. To damage, and that damage is 100. So here we are finished with the trial balance. Now let's see the adjustment again. So in the adjustment, very first adjustment was for closing stock. Closing stock we already calculated according to working mode by closing stock. So closing stock is of working note number 1. We already calculate 14,317. That closing stock supposed to be written over here. Closing stock and that is 14,370. So that is afterwards another is a stationery. For stationery also we have finished the adjustment. Then we can see the furniture. So for furniture we have to calculate the depreciation. So depreciation of furniture of 900 for whole year at 5%, that will be at 5% depreciation will be 45 rupees. So that here minus depreciation 45. So our furniture amount will be 855, and this depreciation supposed to be added over here. Depreciation will be 45. So here we can make the total of the depreciation amount, and that amount will be total of the depreciation will be 2960. So we are finished with the adjustment number 2 and 3. Now let's see the next adjustment. Increase the machine depreciation, that also we are finished. Then furniture depreciation we are finished. Bed debt reserve and discount reserve. Goods withdrawn by Meera, that is also 10%. Now we are finished with the annual salary to Radha. Let's make the effect of that. So here to salary Radha, annual salary supposed to be paid 2000. So here 2000, and then we are going to credit it in the Radha's current account, that is by salary account. In the Radha account it will be 2000. So that's it. So here I think we have finished with all the adjustment. Now let's make the total of the sum. So here from 50,000 if we are going to deduct this of two of these, then 11,500. And if from 32,000 we are going to deduct three of these, then that will be 27,600. So now let's make the total of the credit side. So total of the credit side will be 41,970. From that, if we are going to deduct this amount, 41,970, so balancing amount will be 20,820. So this is our 2 GP, and GP supposed to be transferred to profit and loss account. So that is, this is going to become to the profit and loss account by gross profit, that is from trading account. So that will be 20,820. From there, if we are going to deduct add 701,325, so that will be 22,845. So here again, from that, if we are going to deduct 800, then 500, then 700, then 200, then 800, 103, 200, 525, 2960, 185, 142, and 3730. Balancing amount will be 12,000, and this will be our 2 net profit. And it is supposed to be taken to profit and loss appropriation account. So this will be going to the profit and loss appropriation account on the credit side by profit and loss account. And this is net profit. So this will be 12,000. So here 12,000. From this, if we are going to deduct 5,000, balancing amount will be 7,000, and it will be distributed to partner's current account in the ratio of 3 to 2, that is Radha and Meera. the ratio of 3:2, 4,200 and 2,800. This is supposed to be taken to the credit side of partner's current account by divisible profit. Profit and loss appropriation account, and that will be 4,200 and 2,800. Now let's make the total of the current account. So here, let's see the total. 2,000, 2,000, 4,200, 8,200. From that, if we are going to deduct 5,000, balancing account will be 3,200. Here, 1,000, 1,000, 2,800, 4,800. From that, if we are going to deduct 3,000, balancing amount will be 1,800. So this is supposed to be 1,800. Supposed to be taken to the balance. Balance carried forward. So this balance we are going to write on the capital side, current account of Radha and Meera. So that will be current account will be 3,200 and 1,800. Total will be 5,000. Now, if we are going to make the total side of both assets and liabilities, so that will be 76,097. Both side total must be identical. So students, you may note down this in your notebook. Thank you for watching this video.